afternoon, and thank you for joining us here on the field of Dr. C. Keith Connor Field at Southern Wesleyan University. For today's matchup of the Southern Wesleyan University Warriors versus the Mars Hill Lions. If you're tuning in, you just watched a pop-up to left field for out number one for the Lions. And number 31 for the Lions, Cameron Reynolds, hits a line drive into left field for a single. Pitching today for the Warriors is number 6, Tanner Glass, as he puts that one in there for strike one. And that pitch catches the inside part of the plate as the count goes to 0-2. We're in the top of the first inning, score 0-0, one out. Man on first for the Lions. And the runner goes to second. And he will be safe.
This will be the Warriors and the Lions' second matchup of the season. They faced each other in opening weekend as the Lions took the game 6-1. So the Warriors will be looking to get this game. Excuse me, the Warriors won that game 6-1, so they'll be looking to get their second win.
And that is hit into center field towards Ty King Richards, who is under to make the play. And the man from second tags and makes it to third safely. So Lions here have one on, two out here in the top of the first, score still 0-0. That pitch from Glass is inside for strike one. And a swing and a miss there from Casey Mahiney. Brings the count to 0-2. And that pitch up high from Glass, trying to get him to chase for ball one. Count 1-2, two outs, and a swing and a miss for out number 3, and that will end the inning. And we'll be back at the bottom of the first after this. back here in the bottom of the first inning as the Warriors will come up to bat, starting with number one, Ty King Richards.
Ty's got two hits on the season so far, and he's batting about 118 right now.
And that pitch there by number 44, Sam Kaplan, goes by Richards to bring the count to 1-2, but Richards hits the next one to right field for out number one. Bat now for the Warriors is number two, Timo Hsiao, who hits a screaming foul ball back to the net to bring the count to 0-1. And that one is a bouncer up the middle, but the shortstop is there to make the play over to first for out number two for the Warriors.
Bring up Tanner Glass for the Warriors. He's leading the team with seven hits so far this season, batting 333.
And that pitch from Kaplan comes and catches that inside part of the plate to even up the count at 1-1. And Glass hits it to right field. And the right fielder for the Lions, number 29, Jackson Lee, was not able to make the grab, and so Glass is able to secure a double.
Number 30, Parker Pillsbury.
That'll bring up Parker Pillsbury for the Warriors. Got four hits on the season, and he's batting about 267 so far, and he's picked up a home run already on the season.
And so one out, two outs, and one on here for the Warriors as the pitch gets away from the catcher and actually hits Pillsbury. So that will put men at first and second with two outs. Two on and two out here for the Warriors in the bottom of the first. And that pitch low and inside for ball one. And Posick hits it over to third, right to the third baseman for the Lions, who will step on the bag and get out number three.
Yeah.
We are tied here heading into the second inning, and you're listening to the SWU Sports Network. are back in the top of the second inning as the score is tied 0-0 and Glass pitches for strike one. And another fastball by Glass as he brings the count to 0-2. Foul ball hit by number 7 for the Lions, Ruben Trillo. Glass puts it low and outside, trying to get him to chase, and unable to do so, brings the count to 1-2. And that pitch low again. Glass looking for that outside pitch, trying to get Trillo to chase, unable to do so, brings it to a full count. 3-2, and nobody out here in the top of the second. And a swing and a miss from Trillo for out number 1 as Glass gets his second strikeout of the game. First pitch low again by Glass and the catcher Posick looking for him to get it up a little higher, just like that one, which the batter for the Lions, number 12, Scotty Lee, takes a swing and a miss at. That ball fouled off towards the Warriors dugout. And the count is now 1-2 on Lee as he steps back in and hits a bounder over to third base. Third baseman able to gather it and throw to first for out number 2. Two outs here in the top of the second as up to bat for the Lions now, number 6, Jordan Lath hits a foul ball down the third base line. That ball over to the third baseman again for the Warriors. And a great play there by the first baseman, number 14, Sawyer Price, to come off the bag and get the tag for out number 3. We're still tied 0-0 after the top of the second inning. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network. bottom of the second inning. The score tied 0-0. As Kaplan puts it outside for ball one. That one swung on and missed by the batter, number five, Devin Patrick, for the Warriors. Count even now, 1-1. Nobody out. As Patrick hits it into left field, and it drops in, and he will pick up a single.
Warriors looking to get a run here early in the bottom of the second. Last time these two teams met, neither team was able to score until the bottom of the seventh, and the Warriors put up three runs.
That's right. Looking to get on the board early here today. And they're looking to number 14, Sawyer Price, a senior, to do just that. As that pitch from Kaplan is inside for ball one. And Kaplan puts that one inside again. And the count now 2-0 on Price. As Patrick is on first. Nobody out here. And he puts that ball outside. Not going after the batter right away. But the count, 3 balls, no strikes. And that one catches the inside part of the plate for strike one. And Price takes a big swing at that one. And unable to make any contact. And so the count is full. 3 balls, 2 strikes. And a man on first, nobody out for the Warriors. And Price gets a piece of that one to stay alive as he fouls it back into the screen. And a high foul ball up over the Lions' dugout. Keeps the count at 3-2. And that one tied Price up. And the Lions will get the out at second as Price goes to first base safe. And so the Warriors will stay with a man on first with one out now. And up to bat now is number 8, Cole Rogers. That one swung on and missed by Rogers as it was low and away. And that brings the count to 0-1. And he pokes that one over to the second baseman, who will throw on to first. And the runner safely back into second as he took a pretty wide turn there.
Now batting number 12, Sean Sute.
But the runner advances over to second base. And the Warriors will have a man in scoring position with 2 outs. And that pitch outside. as Sute stands in and takes ball one. And that one outside again for ball two. Kaplan not really looking to attack the batters here as Sute stands in and takes three straight balls. And that one catches the plate for a strike against Sute. And Sute takes ball four as it once again lands outside. This will bring the Warriors back up to the top of the order with Ty King Richards, as he looks for his first hit of the day. So the Warriors have two on with two out here in the bottom of the second, looking to jump out to an early lead as Kaplan delivers a strike for the first pitch against Richards. Count 0-2. And here's the delivery, and that one is outside for ball one. One ball and two strikes on Richards. As he hits that one to second base, and they toss it to the shortstop to get the third out of the inning. This will close out the second. Score still tied 0-0. You are listening to the SWU Sports Network. And we're here in the top of the third inning for the matchup of the Southern Wesleyan Warriors versus the Mars Hill Lions. Score tied 0-0 still, as number three, Gage Smith, steps in for the Lions and takes ball one inside. And second pitch by Glass, able to make him swing and miss to bring the count to 1-1. And that ball hit right back to Glass as he loses it for a second, but makes a nice pitch over to Price for the first out. Ball ricocheted off his glove, and he lost it on the infield, but able to gather it and toss it to first for the first out. Glass delivers for strike number one against Cody Klein for the Lions. And that ball hit foul down the third base line. Brings the count to 0-2. Here's the pitch from Glass. And Klein swings and misses for strike number three. Quick two outs for the Warriors, which will bring number 34, Austin Treadway, up for the Lions. Top of the third with two outs for the Warriors. And that ball low and outside from Glass brings the count to 1-0. And that ball popped up to right field as they make the catch for out number three. And that will end the inning. A quick top of the third for the Warriors will put them back at the plate, and you are listening to the SWU Sports Network. Back now in the bottom of the third inning, as up to bat for the Warriors is number two, Timo Hsiao, who hits it high over the net to bring the count to 1-1. And that pitch outside brings the count to 2-1. Pitch upstairs from Kaplan unable to catch the strike zone there. Three balls and one strike on Shaw. Nobody out here, bottom of the third, as that one again is rip foul. Full count now on Shaw as he steps in for the delivery. And again, fouls that one. And he rings that one right off the pole with the net. Stays alive here and steps back in. And the delivery from Kaplan is low for ball four. And so Shaw will take first base here for the Warriors to lead off the bottom of the third. And that ball gets away from the pitcher as Shaw will take second base. So Glass steps back in for the second pitch. And again, that ball is low. For ball two. And a good step there by Ruben Trillo, the catcher, to keep Shaw at second base. That pitch in from Kaplan catches the outside part of the plate for strike one. Takes a swing at that one, but unable to reach it as it was down low in the dirt. Evens up the count at two apiece. And the pitcher steps off the rubber to tech on Shaw. Glass awaits the pitch, and here it is. And he swings and misses for out number one as Kaplan battles back and gets the strikeout.
Now batting number 30, Parker Pillsbury.
So the Warriors have a man on second with one out here, bottom of the third. Score is still tied 0-0. Looking for the first runs of the game. As number 30, Parker Pillsbury, will step in to bat. And he hits a pop-up to center field. And the left fielder for the Lions makes the grab for out number two.
Now batting number four, Dawson Postick.
And up to bat now for the Warriors is number four, Dawson Postick. Posick averaging 429 this season. He has six hits, a double, a triple, and a home run right now across the board. And he stands in. And takes the ball. Count 2-0 on Posick. Shaw at second. And that pitch comes in for strike one for Kaplan. two out here for the Warriors. As the pitch comes in and is outside, good stop there by Trillo to keep Shaw at second base. Count 3-1 now on Posick as he stands in again. And that ball comes in. And brings it to a full count. Full count now on Posick. As he hits a pop-up into shallow center field. And the shortstop out to make the grab for out number three. We're still tied here after the third inning. And when we come back, the Lions will be at the plate again. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network. And here in the fourth inning, we have a pitching change for the Warriors as they will bring in number 25, Devin Bond, a freshman from Easley, South Carolina. We're here in the top of the fourth inning with a pitching change for the Warriors as the score is still tied 0-0. And the first pitch in from Bond is ball one. And that pitch fouled back to the screen by number 31, Cameron Reynolds for the Lions. That ball low and outside in the dirt. Count now 2 balls, 1 strike. As That one is hit straight away center field right to Richards, who makes the catch. From Bond, in for a strike against number four, Tyler Lala, who stands in and takes ball one. Count even, 1-1, one out here for the Lions, nobody on. And that pitch in from Bond for a strike. Count 1-2. As that one stays outside, trying to get Lala to chase. And that evens the count at 2 apiece. Ball stays outside for ball three. And Bond has a full count here against Lala. And that one low and inside for ball four. So Lala will take first base.
Now batting number 28, Casey Molini.
And so the Lions will have a man on first as Casey Molini steps in at the plate against Bond. As the first pitch comes in, and it goes for strike one. Score still tied 0-0, as the Lions have one on and one out here in the top of the fourth. As Molini takes the pitch and shows bunt, and it goes for a strike. Count 0-2, and the pitch is hit high to right field, trailing up and caught. And so that'll be out number two.
Now batting number 7, Ruben Trilla.
For the Warriors. And the pitch in is outside for ball one. That one low, but a good stop by Posick to keep the runner at first base as he makes the throw down, trying to catch him. Two balls, no strikes here on Trillo, as the Lions have two out and one on. Trying to get the first runs of the game, and a hit and run play on, as that ball is lined straight to the left fielder for out number three. That'll bring us to the bottom of the fourth inning. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network.
A trip to McAllister's is like visiting a lifelong friend. One who believes the recipe for good times calls for heartfelt conversation over a handcrafted meal, knows just how you like your tea, always has a refill ready, and welcomes every guest with their favorite food made to order. The kind of friend who is always up for trying something new. and who you can count on for that familiar feeling of home. McAlister's Deli, great food brings us together.
We are in the bottom of the fourth inning as the score is still tied 0-0. Both teams looking to be the first on the board as the Warriors step up to the plate, leading off with number 5, Devin Patrick. And Patrick hits a liner to right field into the corner as it goes up against the wall, and he will take 4 second and have it standing up to lead off the inning for the Warriors. Good start here to the inning for the Warriors as Patrick hits a liner to right field for a double. And this will bring up Sawyer Price for the Warriors. And Kaplan will step off and take time. Price attempts the bunt and pops it straight into the air for out number one, trying to advance Patrick from second, but unable to do so. And so this will bring in number eight, Cole Rogers, for the Warriors. Warriors have one on and one out here in the bottom of the fourth, looking to get the first runs of the game. And that ball is low and outside for ball one. That ball high and outside, and Kaplan gets Rogers to chase that one, even up the count, 1-1. That ball hit to the first baseman, who will pitch it to the pitcher for out number two, but the runner does advance to third base for the Warriors. And so the Warriors will have a man on third with two out here in the bottom of the fourth as Soute steps to the plate. And that ball hit high into right field as the Lions make the catch for out number three, and the Warriors threatened but unable to get the run across. This will keep the score tied at zero apiece here, heading into the fifth inning. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network. here at Dr. C. Keith Connor Field for the start of the fifth inning as the score is tied 0-0 for the matchup of the Southern Wesleyan Warriors versus Mars Hill Lions. And the pitching change for the Warriors brings in number 28, Rhett Wages, whose first pitch into number 12, Scotty Lee, is a strike. That ball comes in, and Lee fouls it to the backstop and brings the count to 0-2. Ball just inside there for Wages. As the count is now 1-2. And that ball fouled down the right field line. Wages looking for Lee to chase, unable to do so. Evens up the count at 2 apiece. And that ball again inside. As that'll bring us to a full count here. As Lee stands in against Wages. That ball high and inside. And the Lions have their leadoff man on with a walk.
Now batting number 6, Jordan Lathan.
And so the Lions will have one on and nobody out here in the top of the fifth as number 6, Jordan Lath, comes to the plate. And he chases that one that was low in the dirt for strike one. Bunt is shown as the pitch goes outside. One ball, one strike here on Lath. As the Lions have a man on first and nobody out here in the top of the fifth inning. As the runner takes off, and the throw by Posick was in time, but the second baseman unable to hang on to it and make the tag. So the runner will be safe at second base for the Lions. The throw was spot on by Posick, but the second baseman for the Warriors unable to hang on to it. And so the Lions now have a man on second with nobody out as Lath again shows bunt. And the ball goes outside as Wages will not throw in. Count 3-1 now as Lath stands back in. And here's the pitch from Wages. As it catches the outside part of the plate for strike two. Full count now on Leith. As there is still nobody out here in the top of the fifth inning. Score tied 0-0. And a swing and a miss as Posick has to throw down to first to get the out, and does.
Now batting number 3, Gage Smith.
One out, one on here for the Lions, as number 3, Gage Smith, will step into the box. And Wages will step off to bring the runner back to second. And the pitch in, a good pitch by Wages, as he's able to get the curve and catch the inside part of the plate for strike one. And a swing and a miss there by Smith, as the count quickly goes to 0-2. One on, still one out for the Lions, as Wages delivers. And it is a foul tip. As the foul ball goes off the foot of the batter. To keep the count at 0-2. And the pitch in as the runner takes off for third, but a foul ball hit up over the screen by Smith keeps him alive. And that pitch in is inside for strike three.
Now batting number 8, Cody Klein.
And so the Lions still have a man on second and now have two out here in the top of the fifth, as the score is still 0-0. And into the box now is Cody Klein. Wages will step off and check the runner at second. And the pitch in is pop foul, but Price is over to make the catch for out number 3. We're still scoreless here in the fifth inning as we go to the bottom of the fifth, and the Warriors will be at the plate. You are listening to the SWU Sports Network.
We want to gather and build friendships and families, strengthen community, and sustain athleticism. Here, we celebrate fun, hard work, and enjoy the wonderful world around us. Here, we want your downtime to be just as amazing as your game time. And finally, when it's time to leave, we hope you'll want to stay.
A trip to McAllister's is like visiting a lifelong friend, one who believes that good times call for heartfelt conversation over a handcrafted meal, and who you can count on for that familiar feeling of home. McAllister's Deli. Great food brings us together.
Top of the order for the Warriors as Ty King Richards stands in and shows bunt but fouls it off for strike one. And Richard steps in again and hits a shallow fly ball to right field. But the Lions make the catch for out number one.
Now batting number two, Timo Schau.
And so the Warriors begin with an out. As Timo Schau steps in and rips one foul over the Lions dugout. For strike number one. And so Schau hits a bunt back to the pitcher and unable to get his footing. And so he will be safe at first base. Awareness by Schau to catch the infield off guard as he is now at first base with one out, and number six Tanner Glass will step in. Kaplan checks back to first, but Schau is safe with the dive back in. Kaplan steps off again, unaware of where the runner was, but trying to keep him at first. And Glass still looking for the first pitch as it comes in. And he takes a big swing and miss at the first pitch for strike one. Kaplan checks back again to keep an eye on Schau, who is taking a sizable lead at first base right now. And the Warriors looking to be the first on the board here in the bottom of the fifth, as the score is still tied 0-0. And Schau takes off in a hit and run play as Glass hits it to the third baseman, who gets the out at first. But the runner does advance to second base as number 30, Parker Pillsbury, will step in and try and bring in the runner. So the Warriors have two outs here and a man on second in the bottom of the fifth inning as Pillsbury steps into the box to try and bring in the first run of the game. There's a sizable gap in the outfield right now between left and center. That ball is high and outside for ball one. And that ball high again. Four ball two. And the count 2-0 on Pillsbury. As the Warriors have a man on second, two out. And that one catches the outside part of the plate for strike one. Count 2-1. Two out here. Bottom of the fifth. As Pillsbury hits it to the second baseman who gathers it and throws on to first for the third out. That'll conclude the fifth inning. Score still tied 0-0 here at Dr. C. Keith Connor Field. You are listening to the SWU Sports Network.
A trip to McAllister's is like visiting a lifelong friend. One who believes the recipe for good times calls for heartfelt conversation over a handcrafted meal. Knows just how you like your tea, always has a refill ready, and welcomes every guest with their favorite food made to order. The kind of friend who is always up for trying something new, and who you can count on for that familiar feeling of home. McAllister's Deli, great food brings us together.
We are back here in the top of the sixth inning as the Warriors and Lions here are in a battle of defense, really, as there has not been much offense shown by either side. And that shows on the scoreboard with the score tied 0-0. And so the pitching change for the Warriors as number 7, Bryson Fowler, will step in and get out number 1 rather quickly as number 34, Austin Treadway, hits a bunt straight back to him, and he throws it to first base for the first out. And that pitch will come in for strike 1. On number 31, Cameron Reynolds. That one foul tip back into the mitt for strike two from Fowler. Fowler looking for him to chase that one low and outside and doesn't get him to bite. So the count now 1-2 with one out here. That one popped up and Price runs over to the dugout with Posick as it lands inside the fence. And so Reynolds hangs in there. Count still 1-2 with one out for the Lions. And the pitch is roped down the third base line. Great play there by the third baseman who makes a strong throw over to Price for out number two. Third baseman number two, Timo Schau, who made a great pick play off his backhand and a strong throw across the infield to Sawyer Price. And the first pitch in from Fowler to Lala is ball one. And Lala swings and misses to even up the count at one apiece. That one hit long and high down the left field line as it lands just before the fence, but the left fielder lost his footing and fell. And so Lala picks up a double for the Lions with two outs here in the top of the sixth inning. And this brings up number 28, Casey Mawini, as both teams still looking for the first runs of the game. And Fowler's pitch right down the middle for strike one. That pitch low and outside from Fowler evens up the count at one apiece. And so Fowler will step off and keep the runner at second. And that one ripped foul back to the screen for strike number two. Count 1-2 on Mawini. Two outs here. Man on second for the Lions. As the pitch comes in and is hit down the second base side, and he's unable to grab it, but the runner comes in to home and is safe as Posick missed the tag. And that'll be the first run of the game as the Lions take a 1-0 lead here in the top of the sixth inning. Awkward play there for Cole Rogers. And so unable to get the throw to first, and the throw home was in time, but the runner does evade the tag. And so that ball in for ball one. As that ball gets away from Price, and the runner will take for second and be safe. So a wild throw there by Fowler as Posick will step out and have a talk to calm him down. and keep this at a one-run game. Good pitch there by Fowler as it is foul tipped back into the mitt for strike one. Pitch outside brings the count to 2-1. And there's 2 outs here for the Lions as they have a man on second again, looking to add to their lead. That ball roped down the left field line and foul. As the count is even at 2-2. Trillo fouls it back to the backstop to stay alive here. And time is allowed to the hitter. Pitch in, hit down the third baseline as Shaw gathers and throws across the diamond to first to Price for out number three. That ends the top of the sixth inning, but not before the Lions are able to get a run on the board. And so your Warriors trail 1-0 here heading into the bottom of the sixth. You are listening to the SWU Sports Network.
When we travel, we expect to be uncomfortable. We long for the security and the comfort of home. But here at Best Western, we focus on providing you with the most ample accommodations imaginable. We want to be your home away from home. Your security and comfort when the road is long. We want to gather and build friendships and families. Strengthen community and sustain athleticism. Here, we celebrate fun, hard work, and enjoy the wonderful world around us. Here, we want your downtime to be just as amazing as your game time. And finally, when it's time to leave, we hope you'll want to stay.
Back here in the fourth inning, we are in the bottom of the sixth inning as number four, Dawson Posick, steps into the bat. Top of the inning, the Lions got a run across. across to take the lead, as that is the first run of the game. And so the Warriors will look to fight back here in the last few. And tie it back up here in the sixth inning. Count even, one ball, one strike for Posick. As he takes a swing and a miss for strike two. And he swings again. And does not make contact, and so that will be the first out. As the Lions had made a pitching change and brought in number 41, Connor Presnell. And that out will bring number 5, Devin Patrick, up to the plate for the Warriors. And that ball low in the dirt for ball one. Pitch goes for ball two as Patrick steps in and takes it. And that one low and inside. Count 3-0 on Patrick as the Warriors have one out and nobody on here in the bottom of the sixth inning. And that'll be ball four as Patrick will take first base and bring in number 14, Sawyer Price. Warriors now one on, one out here in the bottom of the sixth as they trail by a run. And Price stands in and takes strike one from Presnell. That ball high and outside. For ball one. Count even, 1-1 on Price. As he hits it over the second baseman's head and gets another hit for the Warriors as they now have a man on first and second with one out. And this brings up number 8, Cole Rogers. Warriors with one out have a man in scoring position looking to tie this game up. Rogers on the season hitting .333 and stands in and takes ball one low in the dirt. Another stop there by Trillo to keep the runners from advancing. And so Presnell will take the stance and deliver. As Rogers hits it foul down the third baseline. 1-1. And Rodgers swings and misses, and Price jogging back to first base and got caught in a pick play for the second out. Catcher to first. Heads up there, play there by Trillo as Price was heading back to the bag. And he picked him off. And so the Warriors with two outs now and only one on, as they still trail by a run. Count even now, 2-2 on Rodgers. And that ball inside and ties him up for strike three for the third out. That ends the sixth inning. The Warriors still trail 1-0. When we're back, we will be in the seventh inning. You are listening to the SWU Sports Network. And we're back in the start of the seventh inning as the score is 1-0 in favor of the Mars Hill Lions. Fowler's still on the mound here for the Warriors as he delivers a ball and puts that one low in the dirt as the count goes to 2-0. And a good pitch there as it catches the outside part of the plate. And that brings the count to 2-1 on Lee. And Lee hits a roper into right field. But the right fielder for the Warriors does not have to go far to make that catch and does for the first out. And coming out now to the mound is the assistant coach, Justin Pollock, as he will call for the pitching change. And coming in for the Warriors now is number 22, Lathan McLean. As he will take over here in the top of the seventh with one out. McLean, a sophomore from Due West, South Carolina. Will take over. For Fowler here in the seventh inning. And we're back here in the top of the seventh inning as the Lions have one out and nobody on. And the pitching change for the Warriors brings in Lathan McLean as his first pitch is fouled off for strike one. And a high pop up there by Jordan Lath while leaving the count at two apiece. And the count, 2-2, one out here as McLean delivers. And Lath fouls it back to hang in and keep the count at 2-2. And that one again, a high pop-up back here to the booth. As Lath hangs in. And another foul ball. Lath hanging in. Not willing to give up the strikeout. That one across the road for Lath as it carried a long way. But went foul. And so here's the delivery, and that will be high for ball three. And so the battle here between Lath and McLean will end with McLean striking him out for the second out. And so a good battle there, but McLean gets the best of him, putting it down and inside to tie up Lath.
Now batting number three, Gage Smith.
And this will bring in Gage Smith for the Lions to step in against McLean. And he swings and misses for strike one. And the second pitch fouled back and out of play as the count grows to 0-2. That pitch just outside as McLean was looking for strike three, but that will bring the count to 1-2. And McLean gets the strikeout as he ties him up on the inside to come in and strike out the two he faces. And that'll conclude the top of the seventh inning. When you come back, the Warriors will be at the plate, trailing by one still. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network. And we're back here in the bottom of the seventh inning as the Warriors still trail 1-0 to the Mars Hill Lions. And stepping into the box is Sean Soute, who takes ball one inside. And Soute bunts it, but a good play by the pitcher, Presnell, to get it to the first baseman for out number one. So the Warriors will be back at the top of the order as Trillo will head out and talk with Presnell. As Ty King Richards will step into the box. That pitch outside for ball one to Richards. And Richards hits it to the shortstop and runs it out, but a good pick there by the first baseman for out number two. Two outs here for the Warriors in the bottom of the seventh as Timo Shao will step to the plate. And he hits a high hop foul over the third base bag. Count 0-1 to Shao. And he takes ball one. And Shao hits a line drive to right field, but the catch is made by the outfield for the Lions. And so three up and three down for the Warriors as they still trail 1-0 after seven. We'll be back with the top of the eighth inning. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network. Here in the top of the eighth inning at Dr. C. Keith Connor Field with the Warriors versus the Lions. Lions still lead by a score of 1-0 as number 8, Cody Klein, steps in for the new pitcher, number 55, Cole Standifer for the Warriors, who just delivered a strike. And that will even up the count at 1-1. And a good pitch there by Standifer. As he delivers a strike. Count 1-2. As Klein swings and misses for strike number 3. And that is out number 1. For the Warriors.
Now batting for the Lions, number 34, Austin Treadway.
Austin Treadway steps in now for the Lions and takes a pitch low in the dirt for ball one. And here's the pitch. And that one catches the outside of the plate for strike 1. pitch. Unable to get the outside part of the plate. And so the count goes to 2-1. That one outside again. As the count is now 3-1. On Treadway. And so Treadway will take 4 and head down to first base. And so the Lions will have one on and one out. As number 31, Cameron Reynolds, is in the box for the Lions. Count 0-1. And the runner goes, but a good pitch by, good throw by Posick, who gets the runner for the second out. And here's the pitch. As it catches the outside part of the plate for strike 2. And that pitch low for 2. And so the count even here, 2 apiece, with 2 out and nobody on for the Lions. Warriors looking to keep this a 1-lead game. 1-run game as Reynolds fouls it back to the backstop to stay alive. Full count for Reynolds as he continues to face Standifer. And here's the pitch as it is popped up into the air to left field. And the Warriors are under it and make the catch for out number 3. That's the top of the 8th inning. When we're back, we will be with the Warriors as they come to the plate, still trailing by 1 run. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network. We're here in the bottom of the eighth inning, and it has not been much offense. Only one run scored today, and that was by the Lions in the sixth inning. So the Warriors still trail by one as number six Tanner Glass steps into the box. And he takes ball one from the new pitcher for the Lions, number 32, Brett Pope. And Trillo heads out to the mound to get the signs right with Pope. The count 1-0 on Glass as Pope gets the sign and delivers. And is inside for ball two. And Pope loses a little bit of control on the mound. And throws it away for ball three. And puts that one in for strike one. And Glass looking to tie this game up with one swing of the bat. Brings us to a full count, 3-2. Nobody out, nobody on. And he swings for it again, but does not make contact. That is the first out for the Warriors this inning, and that'll bring up number 30, Parker Pillsbury. And here's the pitch, as it is low for ball one on Pillsbury. That pitch from Pope outside for ball two. Inside. So a quick 3-0 count here for Pillsbury, looking to just get on base and get into a scoring opportunity for the Warriors. And again, it is inside for ball four. And so the Warriors will have a man on first with one out here. And number four, Dawson Posick, will come up to bat. Posick foul tips it back into the mitt for strike one. Warriors have one on and one out here in the bottom of the eighth inning, as Posick has an 0-1 count on him. And here's the pitch as it goes over the plate for strike two. Warriors still trying to get some offense going. As as Postick hits it into center field deep. And the center fielder there to make the catch for out number two.
Okay,
and so this will bring up number five, Devin Patrick, for the Warriors.
Now batting number five, Devin Patrick.
And so the Warriors still have a man on first, with two out now in the bottom of the eighth inning as Patrick steps in. And he hits a line drive to center field. But again, the center fielder for the Lions there and makes the play. And that is three outs for the Warriors as they leave another man on base. And still trailed by a run, but that concludes the eighth inning. So this will bring us to the ninth. And you are listening to the SWU Sports Network. We're here in the top of the ninth inning as the pitching change for the Warriors brings in number 11, Aaron Bennett, a junior from Helen, Georgia, to step in against number four from the Lions, Tyler Lala. And that pitch outside for ball one. Pitch 1-0. sign Talala as he doesn't chase. And a ground ball to the third baseman, Shao. Throws it across the infield to Price for out number one. And so the Lions have one out here, top of the ninth, as Casey Mawinney will step in.
That sounds a lot better, actually. Sounds a lot cleaner.
And he takes strike one from Bennett. And here's the pitch. And it is left outside to even up the count. One ball, one strike. And a ground ball to the shortstop as Sute picks it, but does not get it to first base in time. So an infield hit for Mawinney. And so the Lions will have one on and one out here in the top of the ninth as Ruben Trillo comes to the plate. And that ball hit down the left field line. As the throw back in, we'll keep runners at first and second. And we will have another mound visit here from the Warriors to try and keep this game at a one-run lead for the Lions. And so the Lions have two on and one out here as number 12, Scotty Lee, will step in to face Aaron Bennett. And that pitch lone inside for ball one. Here's the pitch, and it is hit very shallowly to right field as the runners will advance, and the bases will be loaded here in the top of the ninth inning. And so the Lions have the bases loaded here in the top of the ninth with one out as Jordan Lath comes up to the plate for now, but they will make a hitting change and bring in a pinch hitter, number 14, Paul Martin. So an offensive move here by the Lions, trying to increase their lead over the Warriors. And stretch out this game. But that pitch in from Bennett for a strike. And here's the pitch. And that ball is left inside for ball one. There hasn't been much offense today, but the Lions do threaten here in the ninth inning with the bases loaded and one out. And a swing and a miss there by Martin. Brings the count to 1-2. And so Bennett and the Warriors looking to keep this game at a one-run deficit. As after this, they will be heading into the bottom of the ninth. And the pitch in is swung on and missed by the pinch hitter Martin. And so the offensive substitution does not pay off for the Lions. And this brings in number three, Gage Smith, to possibly bring across another run for the Lions. And so the Lions still have the bases loaded with two outs here in the top of the ninth. As Smith steps in against Bennett and takes strike one. Pitch in there leads to strike two. And so quick 0-2 count here on Smith as he is looking to increase the lead for the Lions, and Bennett is looking to keep this at a one-run game for the Warriors. Count 0-2, two out, bases loaded here, top of the ninth. And here's the pitch. And a swing and a miss. As Posick is able to hang on.
Who's hitting, Devin?
I need a new center fielder. I believe you.
And so the Lions threaten with bases loaded but do not score. And we are heading into the bottom of the ninth. The Warriors trail 1-0 to the Lions. You're listening to the SWU Sports Network. bottom of the ninth inning. The Southern Wesleyan University Warriors trail by one run as number 14, Sawyer Price, steps in against a new pitcher, number 10, Carlton Jackson, a redshirted sophomore from Cherryville, North Carolina. And the first pitch in for a ball. That one also low and outside for ball two. So a quick 2-0 as Price steps in and hits a pop-up foul, trailing. And the first baseman makes the catch along the fence for out number one.
Why did you fall in the sinkhole?
Dangerous territories over there with the sinkhole, but may able to make the play. This brings up number eight for the Warriors, Cole Rogers. And the first pitch in is inside for ball one. And that second pitch catches the outside corner and evens the count at 1-1. And the count 2-1 as Rogers takes a swing, but did not seem like he wanted to. Looked like he wanted to hold up, unable to. Evens the count, two balls, two strikes. And that one right back to the pitcher, who will flip it on to first base for the second out. And so the Warriors will also make an offensive substitution and bring in number 20, DJ Ludwig, a sophomore from Aiken, South Carolina, to try and keep this game alive as they trail by one here in the bottom of the ninth. That ball hit foul for strike one. And here's the pitch. And Ludwig hits a foul ball way back over the screen. And so it's an 0-2 count with two outs here in the ninth inning as Ludwig is trying to keep this game alive for the Warriors. And that ball outside for ball one as Ludwig continues to hang in there. Count 1-2 with two outs, nobody on for the Warriors, and the pitch is outside again for ball two. And the pitch inside will bring us to a full count here for Ludwig, who is getting his money's worth at this at-bat. Count 3-2 with two outs, and here's the pitch as Ludwig hits it to the shortstop and looks to run it out. But the throw across the infield is in time for out number three. And so that'll do it here for us at Dr. C. Keith Connor Field as the Warriors drop this one 1-0 to the Mars Hill Lions. Thank you for listening and watching the SWU Sports Network.